me today from Blue Star Capital. I'm joined by Tony Fabrizi. Tony, nice to see you.
Good afternoon, Andrew. Hope you're keeping well. The team at Proactive are keeping well.
And you, Tony, look, really interesting times, uncertain times that we're in at the moment. So good to have the opportunity for a chat and a catch-up as far as the portfolio. Could we start with SatoshiPay? What's the latest with these guys?
Yes, well, SatoshiPay have had the investment management for nearly 3 years, and there's been quite a lot of involvement in the company since we took the investment. So it started off as a micropayments business, using blockchain instead of blockchain. And I think what they're trying to do, and I think people should appreciate this, is it's fairly pioneering work using blockchain. So unfortunately, when you're involved in something like that, it does take time. So the initial market they went into, micropayments, is a great solution they came up with, but unfortunately, the commercial traction has been much slower than any of us hoped. But the key thing that I'd like to get across is that the company have not been sitting still waiting for that market to come to them. So they have moved now very clearly in a new direction, which is B2B payments. And this is a sort of global market dominated by the banks. We feel it's quite an inefficient market. So costs are quite high, timing's slow. It's not very transparent. And SatoshiPay solution really, I think, fills all of those issues. So very, very exciting times for the company moving into that area. And to give you an idea of the how they're doing there, they've had some initial, they're not live yet, so it's still in beta, but they have a number of customers already lined up. And I think the unlike micropayments, there is a significant market here. They're not trying to build something from scratch, just playing into a market which is very significant anyway. So I think it's very, very exciting times for SatoshiPay, and we're very confident.
Is it fair to say some investors suspect they've gone a little bit quiet? Some might reckon they haven't quite delivered, but you're suggesting a lot is actually going on behind the scenes here.
Yes, I think, Andrew, that's right. I mean, I share people's frustration perhaps with what appears to be a fairly slow progress of the company. But I think people, as they have to realize what they're trying to do, what SatoshiPay is quite pioneering. And it's never easy. I mean, if you look back at the internet when it first started with all those many years ago, there are a lot of companies started at that point that didn't look like they were going to be successful, and they've become giants today. So I believe blockchain could be another example of that. And very much hope that SatoshiPay is able to come through. I think it will, and hopefully be a big player in that market.
Have we seen some developments being made at Sthaler?
Yes, well, Sthaler is our second payments business. So obviously SatoshiPay is the first, and we invested in Sthaler many, many years ago. And again, I'd say disappointing in terms of commercial traction to date, but we have recently mentioned to people that there is possibility of quite a large contract in Egypt. And this is the first real commercial traction that they can achieve. But it's not just a small contract, it is, it's a very significant contract across the country. So if they were to successfully secure that contract, it would be a complete game changer for the company in terms of financial performance and its valuation. So that's, again, very exciting times, although on the face of it, commercially, they haven't really achieved what we might have hoped so far. But, just to get an example, this COVID-19 obviously is impacting on a lot of companies, and timing on this deal is going to be impacted. But I still feel it's something we can get, hopefully, some news on before too long.
What about eSports? There's a lot of talk around this, given the restrictions and the lockdowns and people stuck in their homes. You've got your fingers in a few different pies as far as this area.
Yeah, so we made the investment, if you remember, back in November, and this was brought to us by Jonathan Bixby of Six Investments, which is a portfolio approach. And, eSports has obviously, don't want to say it too loudly, but it has benefited from what's been going on. I mean, a lot of people staying at home, playing computer games, and, it has evolved quite quickly. So it's already an enormous sport, and I think when people talk about eSports, there are sort of three areas that we're looking at. One is the actual professional teams, so such as the equipment of the Premiership football team. Then you have the infrastructure plays, and then you have the sort of leagues that they're trying to set up. It might be a cricket league, might be a football league. And so there's different companies playing in these different fields, and our investments cover all three. So we've got quite a good breadth of coverage there, and also globally as you remember, we have global coverage. So we've had a bit of excitement so far. A couple of companies have announced deals, potential deals, I should say. So the Canadian company is looking to list in Canada. The Australian business is looking at a merger and at a listing. So, but both of those deals are very much dependent upon market conditions, and obviously with the closure of lots of markets and more difficulty in that area. So there's probably going to be a delay in some of these deals, but I believe the opportunity is still very, very significant.
Do you feel that your investments in each of these firms are sufficient enough to move the dial should one of them really succeed and take off?
Yes, I do, because we've come in on really first round, and you know it is a risky investment for us. But the upside, I think, is you know it's not doubling our money. You know, it's 10, 20 times our money type returns that we're looking for. So I think you know any one of them, if they come off, could be a very significant uplift for Blue Star. If we get two or three happening, then you know the potential is obviously quite nice. But the other thing we've recently announced, Andrew, is a small investment in a mobile gaming company. So we announced last Friday we've invested a small amount of money into a company called Leaf Mobile. It's already listed 2 days ago in Canada, TSX, and it's up 50% since we invested. So that's a nice start. It looks very cheap compared to the comparables, so we think it's got quite a long way to go. If we'd had more money, we'd probably put more in, but you know, unfortunately, we have to cover up, you know, make sure we raise enough money to do these deals. So hopefully, at some point, one of our investments will deliver on a big scale, and then we'll have the capital we need to really deploy it in a sensible way.
And of course, you raised a bit of cash recently. Was that to go towards this deal, was it?
Yes, it was, Andrew. Yeah, so we put some money into that deal and some of it was just used for working capital. I'm pleased to say that the funding actually came from Jonathan Bixby, who introduced the eSports deals to us. So Jonathan has now got quite a big investment in the company. He also has a number of warrants. So he's potentially the largest shareholder in the company. If he has to exercise all his warrants, his investment would be towards £1.5 million in the company. So you know, that gives you an idea of what, you know, what his plans are.
And what about your immediate plans then? Is it about nurturing the existing portfolio, or are you out there looking at other potential opportunities?
We are. We're still looking at deals, but I'd very much like one of our deals to really deliver in terms of NAV uplift, and also, you know, our share price remains sort of well below our NAV, almost 50% discount for our NAV. And you know, I believe our NAV is probably understated. So, you know, we don't want to raise too much money at these levels. We really want to get the price more reflective of what we believe the business is worth.
Nice to see you, Tony. Thanks for your time.
Andrew, pleasure. Thanks very much for the call.